Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. My name is Monika and in this video we are going to talk about how to rotate objects in Illustrator's perspective grid. So how would you draw this roof or other rotations? And I'm going to start with simpler ones. So let's select this, and I'm going to hide it by pressing Command 3 on Windows. That this would be Control 3. So when you draw something in the perspective grid, you can take a shape tool like the rectangle tool, select one of these perspective planes, and then just draw something in the grid. And now you can take the perspective selection tool, which is below the perspective grid tool, and then you can edit what you have just drawn in perspective. So you can move it around and you can scale it. What you can't do is rotate it. This is a bounding box, but still you cannot use the perspective selection tool to rotate this. So how would you go about that? Now, in order to do that, there are two options. One is when drawing your shape, you do not start directly in perspective, but you go outside of it, clicking in the outer ring. So this is cyan. And then you can draw a shape, which is now just a flat shape, not in perspective. And then you can take the selection tool and rotate it. Then you can take the perspective selection tool and then select a plane and drag this into the perspective grid. So there it is. There's another option. And again, this starts outside of perspective. You draw the shape and then you make a symbol out of it. So you go to Window, Symbols, and then drag the shape into it. This is a wall. This is now a symbol instance, and you can take it with the perspective selection tool, select a perspective plane and drag it into it. This is now a normal perspective, what would be expected. So you can also rotate this later because the symbol can be edited. So you take the selection tool, double click it, and then you're in symbol editing mode. And there you can just rotate this. And with another double click, go outside. And you see it has been rotated. Also in the symbol panel, it has been rotated. So all instances of that symbol would be rotated this way. That's okay. So this is how you can do it. Now, how would you go about that roof? So these are actually perspective objects and they behave like in perspective. So this is all real. But what about the roof? Can you do this kind of things as well? So again, let's start outside of the perspective and I'm going to start with a rectangle and then first make the front of that house. So let's put an anchor point up here and then take this anchor point, move it up, and there we have the front of the house. And then let's take the perspective selection tool, select the perspective plane, and then let's get this down here into the perspective grid. I'm going to take these and move them to the back. Now, in order to get that roof, I cannot create it using rectangles and rotating them inside the perspective grid. This is just not possible. So in order to do that, I have to fake it. And to do that, I have to make reference objects. And then later on, I can draw that object I need. So what I'm doing is creating the backside of the house by selecting this with the perspective selection tool, and then I need to press 5 and Alt. 5 moves this to the back in correct perspective. So this has the same size and everything. It's all correctly constructed, like so. And then I can take the rectangle tool, go to this perspective plane, and then draw that wall. And this also is a perspective object. So if I move that around, you see it's correctly distorted. So let's revert that. This is not possible with the roof. So in order to get the roof, I need to take the pen tool, and then you see I can just click on those anchors, the smart guides hide them, and then I make the roof. And the roof is not a perspective object. So it's just a normal object. If I now take it into the perspective grid, you see this happens. So this is not correct. It has to be like this. It's not editable in perspective. So of course you need to make that when you are finished with the perspective scene, and then you add all those details which are not in perspective to finish your scene. So that's that. But how would you go about drawing a house which is in perspective and then rotate it? So to do that, it's getting really, really, really complex. So you would start with the floor of your house and then prepare the construction by taking the line segment tool and drawing again a reference object, just a line for the roof. Let's make that black. And then you can take these two and rotate them. You have to figure out beforehand how much you need to rotate them. Then you can take the perspective selection tool, move them to the floor like this. So this is rotated now. And what you can then do is select this one. And again, press Alt and 5, move it up like so. So you have the first floor. And then you can take this line, which is also a perspective object. And again, press the 5 and move it up. And then you have a reference object to make your roof. And again, you could take the pen tool and then draw the roof. You have to now make sure that you don't connect. So you press here, press the space bar, and then draw it like so. Again, press here, press the space bar, move it like so, and then you have the roof. So this is what you can do in order to draw rotated objects in your perspective grid, which means you have to think ahead and draw your references to later build your perspective scene. If you like the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.